Okay? And if you are reading one word, pause on the last letter. If you are reading several words, pause on the last word. Okay. So al baytu, in reading we say al bayt. Say
al bayt.
Al thamaru. I said pause in the last letter of if you're reading one word. If you're reading several words, pause on the last letter of the last word. In other words, don't say al baytu, say al bayt.
If
we stop, yes. If you're not, in the sense that, if you're not, then don't. But I mean, for now, we will be stopping at the end of each word.
Okay.
So we won't be saying al-baytu, we'll say al-bayt.
Al-thamar.
Right. Al-bayt.
Al-bayt.
Al-bayt. Al-thamar.
Al-thamar.
Al-salatu wa-zakah.
Al-salatu wa-zakah.
Right. Khubzun wa-laban.
Khubzun wa-laban.
Salihun aw fasiq.
Salihun aw fasiq.
الحسن أو القبيح
أو حسن أو القبيح.
Do you see the rule that we learned earlier? It's أو with the سكون. The second one that has سكون when it comes to همزة to وصل, it must take a كسرة. So we don't say الحسن أو القبيح. We say الحسن أو ال. You see الحسن أو القبيح. Say it. You see the proper word is aw, but you can't have a sukun next to hamza, next to another sukun. With me? So the first sukun mistake, kasra. So instead of aw al qabih, we say aw al qabih. Al hasan aw al qabih.
Al hasan aw al qabih.
Al ma' wal khubz.
Al ma' wal khubz.
Al tamar. التمر واللبن.
التمر واللبن.
جاهل وعالم.
جاهل وعالم.
Okay. الإنسان والفرس.
الإنسان والفرس.
درس وكتاب.
درس وكتاب.
العادل أو الظالم.
العادل أو الظالم.
Right. You see, أو الظالم becomes أو الظالم. Okay. جمال وفرس.
جمل وفرس.
Right. And now we stop on it. جمل وفرس.
جمل وفرس.
Okay. Now I want you to tell me the meanings quickly. البيت means
the house.
Not a house.
The
house.
الثمر.
The fruit.
الصلاة والزكاة. خبز ولبن.
Bread and milk.
صالح أو فاسق.
Pious or transgressive.
Right. الحسن. The beautiful,
beautiful
أو القبيح
or the ugly.
Right. The beautiful
or the
الماء والخبز.
The water and the bread.
Right. Yeah. التمر واللبن.
The fruits and
the dates.
And the milk.
جاهل وعالم.
Ignorant or learned.
And ignorant one or a learned one. الإنسان والفرس.
The man and the horse.
Refer to a singular, yeah, just for context.
The man and the horse.
Okay, Dawson.
Lesson and a book.
A lesson and a book. Right, Al-Adilu, the
just.
Or the oppressor.
Jamalun wa Faras.
A camel and a horse.
You're not technically supposed to translate those. Oh, it says read and translate. Okay, no, brilliant. Right. No, because I didn't remember teaching you Jamalun. But nonetheless, Jamalun is a camel, Farasun is a horse. I don't think there's anything else we didn't learn in that set there. Now, translate the following words or phrases into Arabic. Use the definite article al wherever the words are definite. Now, a horse will just be farasun. Are you with me?
Farasun.
A man will just be?
Insan.
Insan or?
Rajulun.
A man and a horse?
Rajulun wa farasun.
Rajulun wa farasun. Bread and water?
Khubzun
wa ma'un. Bread and water. Right. A man and the fruit and the house. A man, rajulun, wa tamarun, wa baytun. The salah.
Al-salah.
Al-salah and the learned man.
والعالم
والعالم والعالم right لو تنوين الان والعالم right the pious one الصالح and
والظالم
transgressor والفاسق
والفاسق
right the man or the horse الرجل أو الفرس right with me okay the milk and the bread
اللبن
اللبن
والخبز
اي مان اند ذا هورس
الرجل
والفرس
ذا اجلي وان اند ذا بيوتيفول وان
القبيح
والحسن
والحسن اي كات يرون اند اي بوي
وولد
ذا مون اند ذا سن القمر
والشمس
The camel, al jamal, or the horse, awil, faras. Okay, some of them you may have seen in the previous article. Okay, jamal and faras. So, anyway, that's that. Okay, test number one. What is the definition of kalima? It means word. Kalam is speech, but kalima more specifically is any word that has meaning. What I said about kalam, kalam is ride upon each other. In other words, it's compounded and it is spit off the
tongue
and it is beneficial. It means the listener is no longer waiting for any more information. You can extract information. How many types of words are there quickly? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10?
Particles,
nouns and verbs. Define each one with examples. Give me an example of a noun.
Noun is no things.
An example?
Bait.
Bait, right. Baitun. A house. Give me an example of a verb. From whatever you've seen. Dhahaba. Okay, I don't expect you to really know many of those, but dhahaba is a verb. You can take that down, save it for your test. Okay, what is the major difference between a noun and a verb?
Tense.
Which one has tense?
The noun doesn't have
tense. The noun doesn't. The verb has tense, right? How many tenses are there? Three. Okay. From the following words, state whether they are. Ismun fi'lun wa harf. The first one, huwa, means?
Noun.
E. What is huwa?
It's
definite. It's a noun, right?
Noun.
Okay. Min?
That's a particle.
Right? It's a particle or a connector. What does it mean?
It means from.
From. Okay. Daraba?
That's a verb.
A verb, right? Yadhabu?
That's a verb.
Right? Baladun?
It's a noun.
Noun. Al farasu?
Horse.
Noun.
Noun, right? Ila?
Particle.
Connector or particle. Sama'un?
It's a verb. Noun.
Right, it's a verbal noun, so it's a noun. Right? It's correct, it's a noun. Sama'un. Okay? To listen, it's not indicating a tense.
Okay.
Right. But it's indicating the act of listening, just not when.
Okay.
Okay. So, define what is ma'rifah and nakira. What is ma'rifah?
I'm not sure. How do you identify the noun again? You said it's got the al?
It's got al or it's got tanween.
Or tanween.
99.9, yeah, all cases. It either is that or that. It's a noun.
Okay.
Ma'rifah and nakira. What's ma'rifah?
Definite.
Definite. Nakira is?
Indefinite.
Indefinite. What's ma'rifah?
Definite.
Nakira?
Indefinite.
Right. How many types of ismul ma'rifah are there? How many different types of definite are there?
Seven.
Seven categories, right? Say whether the following words are definite or indefinite. Zaydun?
That's definite.
Makkatun?
Definite.
Baladun?
Indefinite.
Indefinite. Balad is a city. Okay, رجل indefinite, a man. الطيب
definite,
right? Because you see al, right? نحن means we, definite, because we can answer who are we, right? الفرس
definite,
definite. حسن
indefinite,
قبيح
indefinite,
هذا
definite,
definite, because I'm referring to this. In the above mentioned words, what type of معرفة and نكرة are they? You can just give me the English. Zaid is a proper noun because it's the name of something. Makkah is a proper noun, it's the name of something. Baladun, it's indefinite, but it denotes the existence of a city. It doesn't speak about what type of city, so it's ism with that. Okay, I'm running very quick through this because this is your homework. But I'm just making sure in case you have any questions here. Okay, so in the above mentioned words, this is question number 9 of test 1. What type of ma'rifa and nakira are they? So nahnu is, baladun is a city. But what type of nakira is it? What type of indefinite? It's ism with that. Just denotes the being, not the quality of the being. Okay, rajulun? is a man.
Man.
Okay, indefinite to definite?
It's indefinite.
Indefinite and denotes the being. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Denotes the
being.
Okay, it's not saying he's a good man, not a bad man, he's just a man. Okay, at-tayyibu, definite or indefinite?
That's definite.
Definite, right? Yeah. And why is it definite? Because of?
Yeah.
Al. Say again?
Very specific.
Yes, that's good. And what type of definite is it? It's the definite that has been made definite because of?
Al.
Okay. Nahnu?
Pronoun.
It's a pronoun, yes. Al-farasu, definite because of the? Right, the al hasanun, indefinite. What type of indefinite? Being or attribute?
Attribute.
Attribute, right. Qabihun,
ugly.
Ugly, definitely indefinite?
Indefinite.
Indefinite?
Attribute.
Attribute, right. Hadha,
definite.
This, and this is a demonstrative pronoun, right? This, okay. Okay, what is the hamza of al called? Hamza to? Waslin. You can give it to me in English also. The Hamza of?
Joining.
Right? Hamza to? Waslin. Join the word Hamza to Al Waladu. How do you say? Huwa to Al Waladu. Do you say Huwa Al Waladu?
No.
Huwa Al Waladu. Right. Huwa Ismun. Now, Ism, the word Ism also has Hamza to Waslin at the beginning. Do you say Huwa Ismun or do you say?
Huwasmun.
Huwasmun. That's it. Huwasmun. Right. You say? Huwasmun. All you do is you skip the Alif. We don't say huwa ismun, we say huwasmun. The same with bismillah. Bismillah is bi ismi. It's bi ismi. Bi ismillah. But we don't say bi ismi, we say bismi. With me? No, because of hamzat wasl. The sunnet is applied to the lamb, but there's no lamb.
You said just now you jump, if it has a similar to lamb, you jump on it.
Yes, but that's assimilating. Assimilating means you double the letter. So bis is no doubling.
Okay.
Think of the sun letters as ash-shamsu. It's al and shamsu. But we don't say al-shamsu,
okay.
We say
ash-shamsu.
Ash-shamsu.
So what's the difference between this and that?
Hamza to wasl, the one is merged and the other one is skipped.
Okay.
Hamza to wasl is like if I'm reading and joining it with the previous word, it's like erasing it from the speech.
Okay.
Right. The other one, it's been merged. Now this is really a technical term. Merged, we mean there's still some form of lam left there.
Okay.
Do you see what I mean? It's more technical if you study Tajweed linguistics, but yeah. Huwa ismun, huwa ismun. There's no doubling and no merging. Huwa ismun, hu wasmun. All we do is just skip. We don't like Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, mi alhamdu, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, mi alhamdu. Now if ha, hypothetically, if ha was a sun letter, then we wouldn't say alhamdu, we would say ahhamdu. Okay, with me? Okay, very good. Now, what's the hamza of this called? Hamza to wasl. Huwa al-waladu, huwa al-waladu. Huwa ismun,
huwa
ismun. Huwa ibnun, huwa ibnun. Okay, now, when al is added to these three words, I will explain that on Monday. All you're going to do is you're going to say al and ismu. Al and ismu. But you don't say al-ismu, you say a-lis, a-lismu. You take the lam and you change it to kasra. Remember the word before hamza to wasl? The word before hamza to wasl. In this case, it's al. And this al has sukun. And hamza to wasl is there. So you can't have sukun and hamza to wasl next to each other. So the one before hamza to wasl must take kasra. So we don't say al-ismu, we say a-lismu. And we skip hamza to wasl. Okay, don't worry, that's in your notes. Okay, al-ibnu, we don't say al-ibnu, we say al-libnu. Okay, what is the noon of tanween? Noon of tanween is that second fatha or second kasra or second
dhamma,
which makes the sound of noon sakina. How is a word having tanween joined to a word having al? The previous word that has tanween, you change the second, you change the noon of tanween to have kasra. Zaydun al-alimu, Zaydu nil alimu. It's in the notes, don't stress. Okay, we will refine it Monday, inshallah, the first part of the session. But everything in the test is in the notes. Read over it again. Okay, what are the huruf shamsiyah and huruf al-qamariyah? Huruf shamsiyah?
Close to the lam.
14 letters that are close to the lam that are merged. That are merged. It's lam and noon and all?
Cousins.
Okay, so it's lam, noon, تا ثا دال ذال را زا سين شين صاد ان ضاد ان طاء ان ضاء نط عين نط غين مثل زياء اوكي اوكي compounds is for Monday inshallah. We start talking about that in more detail. So your homework, let me just see. The homework is here on the white piece here. Memorize vocabulary list number one. What I would say that you should do is with your vocab list. With your vocabulary list, rewrite them. Make flashcards. You can make a note of these things to do. Rewrite them. Make flashcards. Right. So one thing, rewrite, make flashcards. If the things are relative to stuff around your house, there isn't really in this lesson, stick them up. Okay. Complete exercise number one, the one I did with you guys. Okay. Complete test number one that you hand in, that's also what I did with you guys now, in terms of the concepts. There was one more thing, and then you make a list. Make a list of things that you can extract from that list of words that are opposites. Like volume and adid. And also if you think fasil, volume is, I mean, and what you think could be similar, make a list of antonyms, synonyms, and then obviously in the list there's some words that wouldn't apply. Like ignorant, jahilun, and alim, that would apply. Hasanun, qabihun, zalimun, adilun, waladun, bintun. All of those are in there. Okay? And then just search out which words have opposites. Okay? Rewrite them, memorize them. With your flashcards, etc., etc., and then obviously don't worry about the words where the opposites don't apply. Okay? Okay, all of the best, inshallah.
We're going to do like a poem as well in the schedule.
I don't.
We had a poem
with Najib. What's wrong? Inna al kalama indana fal tastami'.
Yeah, you said a poem.
I can do something short, inshallah, one of the sessions.
A lot of evidence in the poem.
The poetry is very complex.
Oh,
see, that's the thing. Poetry is like even those who study majors and even study overseas and even those fluent in Arabic, they struggle with poetry.
Can't you find just one simple poem?
But I will give you like something. I'll see what I can do. If I, we could possibly do it towards the end.
Yeah,
towards the end, or maybe after test two on that last day. Okay. That's cool.
I can even find a poem.
Okay.
One I want to do.
Okay. I don't mind. It's just we gotta make time.
Yeah. It was a short one. It's just a 4-line poem by Imam Shafi.
Okay. Bring it. Email it or something to me, inshallah. What you can do is you can read through this just as a reading exercise. You don't have to translate it. You don't have to stress. The first one here is just Assalamu alaikum wa alaikum salam. Min ayna anti? Ana min Pakistan. Hal anta Pakistani? Naam, ana Pakistani. Ma jinsiyatuki ant? Ana Turki. Ana min Turkiya. Do you guys get a rough idea what I just said now?
Yeah.
Ana min Pakistan. I am from Pakistan. Ana min Turkiya. I am from Turkey. Right. Ahlan wa sahlan. Welcome. Right. Assalamu alaikum wa alaikum salam. Min ayna anti? From where are you? Ana min Misr. I am from
Egypt.
Right. أنا من مصر. هل أنت مصرية؟ Are you Egyptian? نعم أنا مصرية. Yes, I am Egyptian. وما جنسيتك أنت؟ And what is your nationality? أنا سورية. أنا من سوريا. Right. أهلا وسهلا. السلام عليكم وعليكم السلام. اسمي خالد. My name is
خالد.
Right. ما اسمك؟ What is your name? اسمي خليل. كيف حالك؟ How are you? بخير والحمد لله. Good. Praise be to God. وكيف حالك أنت؟ And how are you? بخير والحمد لله. And the girl does it. Okay, هذا أخي. This is my brother. هو مدرس. He is a teacher. He got درس and lesson. أهلا وسهلا. هذا صديقي. This is my friend. هو مهندس. Okay. أهلا وسهلا. مع السلامة. مع السلامة. With peace. Goodbye. See you later. Okay. هذه أختي. هي طبيبة. أهلا وسهلا. هذه صديقتي. This is my friend. هي طالبة. Okay. She is a student. أهلا وسهلا. مع السلامة. Okay. There's no more vocab beyond that. Don't stress, we will go through it. We'll do a lot of drills on this, inshallah. In the second session on Monday, we will go through this and we'll do a half session on one surah, short surah of the Quran. Are there any questions before we conclude? Okay,
oh, yeah,
no problem. Anything else related to the content, about the homework, about the workload? It's going to be fine. It's gonna be fine. Break up the words, inshallah, after every prayer. You will see that some of the word lists are long, some of them are shorter. Okay? The memorization component of your word list, inshallah, the target is set about 200 to 300 words, or 400, somewhere there around, for the 10 days. That's what you memorize, but you will get exposure to over 1,000 words during the course. Okay, later on we'll come to some dictionary work and other stuff and whatnot. And the other thing is, use a page or two pages or something. Cut out the test section there. You can have a section that just is for vocab. So you have your vocab lists, but you should make your own vocab lists as well. Rewrite them, memorize them. Don't stress too much about rewriting, but rewriting once or twice just so that's in your own handwriting is there. And make the flashcards. All of the best, inshallah, and I hope that you benefited from today. Nouns, definite, indefinite, different types of indefinite nouns, different types of definite nouns, what exactly is kalam, speech, what is a word with meaning, and particles and recognizing the definite and indefinite nouns, and also just pronunciation of hamzatul wasl and lam al and hurufu shamsiyah, hurufu qamariyah. That's what we did. Please revise, please go back. Right, we sat 3 hours here because you have the weekend, and it's a long time. We're only meeting on Monday afternoon, so there's today, there's tomorrow, there's Monday morning. Not all your time, half an hour today, hour tomorrow, half an hour on Monday. Inshallah, you can break it up. You can sit with the content. Try not to move forward and let the day go past without reviewing today's work. Okay, because it's interesting today and it's really nice and it's everything you have right now, but you do need to revise because the work will compound and they won't get much more intense. I don't think they're going to get much more intense. People about lesson 6 and 7 may be a little bit complex, but that's already two tough lessons. The rest will be pretty much the same as this. All the best, inshallah. That's about it. Revise, constantly revise. There's something we say, if you have done parts of today before and you found it a little bit boring, there might come a time where there's some stuff that you don't know, so just bear with us, inshallah. And secondly, there's nothing wrong with revision because he who does not master the basics is forbidden from achieving. Okay, so that's why we start that at the beginning. Jazakallah khair, shukran, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. See you on Monday at 1:30. Room 220. That's the same building, right on the opposite end. Okay, sweet.